Bonjour à tous, j'espère que vous allez bien. C'est lundi, so it's on... yeah, Monday, I'm using English, because it's for beginners, so I hope that you're doing fine. Let's take the time to say hello to everybody, because we're polite and we want to greet everyone. Stardust is with us. Evelyn, bonjour. Roman, bonjour. Yossi, bonjour. Omar, Luciana is here too. Vlandrov, bonjour du Pérou, ok, Cosmina est là aussi, Victoria Jacques, coucou, Ella Dongo est avec nous, Hilary est là aussi, Victoria Possé, bonjour, Sundar, bonjour, bonjour, Annabelle est là aussi, Yann Arte, coucou, Andrea, is with us too. Vuslat est là. And then Darktainer. Fadoua. Bonjour, bonjour. And Cassandra. So I think that the others probably will show up during the thing. Don't forget to click on the like button. You know that the like button, this is the only thing I have in mind now during the sessions. Oh, Laurent is joining us. Skate Crisis. Each time I think that I should put some pictures. Don't forget to go and subscribe to Laurent's channel, Skate Crisis, a person who clearly have a crisis because he's been passing the 40 years old, and so he decided to start again skateboarding. And of course, he's breaking every part of his body. But that's just the way he is. Voilà, allez, don't forget that in 6 days, dans 6 jours, c'est l'anniversaire. Youpi, youpi. Okay, so we can start now. Alors, as I've been starting to do last week, I don't do any exercises on that, but then I just want to, invite you to or offer you a few things. And, the classic will be a song. I've been listening to this song today. Therapy Taxi, it's an interesting group, band, that you should probably try to check. And, the latest song that they've been releasing is Été 90. So if you really want to have something, well, quite joyful and then quite energetic and French, this is Therapy Taxi, Été 90. And the movie of the day, this is something that I've been watching a few days ago. It's La Vérité. So it's a movie from Koreeda Hironkazu. So he's a Japanese director, but in that case, the movie is French. And it happens in France. And if you like Catherine Deneuve, Juliette Binoche, Ethan Hawke is playing, but clearly doesn't really have a big role, big part in that movie. It's not, well... I mean, you should watch it, and then we could discuss about that. To my point of view, it's not a great, great movie, but it's quite interesting, in fact. Denora is joining us. Rock is here. Shahi too. Well, Renato, Yossi. Yossi, c'est parti. Okay, so La Vérité, The Truth, if you want to watch it, then I think it might be interesting. We could discuss about it if you want. Don't forget to like, and because I can see that there is only, 28 likes. It's not reasonable. Remember, at least 100, please. Allez, the question of the day. I hope that Yossi and the others are happy because I've been switching to the dark background. So maybe it's better. Maybe it's better. Est-ce que Thérapie La série En Thérapie est populaire en France. En Thérapie, I didn't hear about this series. Give me the link, Yossi, s'il vous plaît. Allez, une question classique. Comment était votre week-end? Comment était votre week-end? Qu'est-ce que vous avez fait? Tell me what you've been doing and how your weekend was. « Allez, Yesero is joining us. Bonjour, Sherilyn is with us too. Tib family is joining too. So don't forget to click and then write me a sentence to tell me how your weekend was. Alors, sur Arte, I will check, Yossi, I will check. Doesn't ring a bell right now, but I will check. Alors, Ella Dongo is the first one to write mon. Remember, you should put the possessive, and the possessive should be in the masculine form here because weekend is a masculine word, so you should put mon, M-O-N. Mon week-end était très bien. Vous lat, week-end tranquille, okay? Vous lat, it was possible to write a sentence for this one. Renato travaillait avec beaucoup de pluie. Oumila, bonsoir, bonsoir, Oumila. Write a sentence, écrivez une phrase pour dire comment était votre week-end, s'il vous plaît. Andrea, je me suis entraîné sur un vélo. Qu'est-ce que vous avez fait sur le vélo, Andrea? Tib, je suis resté à la maison avec mon fils. Remember that the verb rester, when you use the compound tenses, like passé composé in that case, you will have to use as a helping verb être. D'accord? This is something that you just need to keep in mind. So, je suis resté à la maison avec mon fils. Yann Arte bavardé. D'accord, you can make a sentence. Hein. Yesero, je n'ai pas fait grand-chose. C'est comme tous les week-ends depuis, oui, l'épidémie, effectivement. Annabelle Nouvelle travaille. Oh là là, c'est une femme courageuse. Nous disons bravo, Annabelle. Yossi, white background. Ah, Yossi, I thought you wanted a black background and some white text because it's quite trendy now to have this black background option. I don't really know. Well, I've been switching that for you, monsieur. Mercurial. Mon week-end était super parce que je n'ai rien fait. Ben voilà, les meilleurs week-ends. Yossi, calme. Victoria Jacques, mon week-end était OK, c'est passé très rapidement. Nicolas a dit la même chose. Nicolas just said the same thing. It's just like, but it goes so fast. Well, it's a good sign usually. It means that it's nice. Omar, nous, notre week-end chez nous, parce que le temps était très mauvais. Télé en français, relax. Hillary qui nous dit, j'ai fait le ménage. Ça, c'est bien le ménage. Ça occupe la tête. Yulia qui dit 20 km à pied, ça use les souliers. Et oui, la chanson 20 km à pied, ça use, le classique. Abdul Rahman qui nous dit le samedi, je me suis reposé à la maison. J'ai traîné tout le matin du dimanche, il faisait très beau et donc j'ai joué au football. Alors là, formidablement écrit. Denora, j'ai fait du vélo et j'ai été trempé sous la pluie. Bon courage. Le vélo sous la pluie, c'est pas sympathique. Luciana, c'était tranquille. J'ai nagé. Je suis allé à l'église et j'ai regardé des vidéos pour pratiquer le français. Roman, il était bon, mais pas très bon parce que j'étais à la maison. Bah oui. Cosmina, pendant le week-end, j'ai cuisiné. J'ai fait des courses et j'ai fait à mes parents des tests anticorps anti-Covid pour voir si le vaccin a été efficace. Et oui, il a été efficace. Ah ben ça, c'est formidable. Ça, c'est formidable. Donc, juste le premier ou c'est le deuxième ou c'est entre les deux? Cosmina, il faut des détails. Shahi, le week-end dernier, ma famille et moi sommes allés manger dans une pizzeria. Miam, miam. Josh, c'était tranquille parce qu'il n'y avait rien à faire. Ça, c'est bien, Josh. Meilleure technique. Victoria Posse, mon week-end a été formidable. Elle n'est pas modeste, Victoria Posse. Non, formidable. Difficult to beat. Urmila, mon week-end était ennuyeux. Bah alors. Ça, c'est dommage. Mais c'est derrière, c'est le passé. Cassandra, c'était simple. J'ai travaillé et je suis allé au supermarché. Les choses basiques. Rock, j'ai nettoyé la maison. Ça, c'est bien. Yann Arte, je suis allé pour une boisson. Eh ben, ça, c'est bien aussi. Cheryline, j'ai combattu Mewtwo. Oh, ça, c'est du... Mon fils, c'est du Pokémon, ça. Ah, Cheryline, vous vous déplacez avec... Vous lancez les... With Nicolas, each time we've been traveling, each time we had at least one full day for the Pokémon thing, we were going everywhere to try to catch some... C'est ça, hein. J'ai organisé l'armoire à trophées. Gazal, bonjour de Toronto, bonjour Gazal. Write a sentence to say what you've been doing during this weekend. Et Cosmina, 10 jours après le rappel. Alors, vous, Slat, mon week-end a été tranquille, et Stardust, mon week-end a été douloureux. Oui, 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 j'ai formé les doigts, ce n'est pas vraiment facile, mais c'est comme ça, d'accord. Toujours 5 ou Stardust, combien sont peuvent bouger? Allez, plus d'informations s'il vous plaît, nous attendons. Alors, Dali is joining us from Indonesia. Enchanté de vous rencontrer. You can join. So this lesson is for, well, beginners. So it means that it's in English and in French. Tomorrow it will be only in French. And the day after, only in French. D'accord? Allez, find one word. Trouvez un mot qui commence par la lettre C. Un mot qui commence par la lettre C. You can start right now. Alors, Andrea qui commence avec un chien. Mais Andrea, on ne sait toujours pas comment s'appelle votre chien. Andrea didn't tell us what was the name of his beautiful dog because we saw this beauty few days ago, last week, when you sent the picture. But you didn't say what, I mean, the name of your dog was. Dark Tainer, un cheval masculin. Il y a aussi un cœur masculin. Cosmina la Calipédie. Urmila, combien? Mercurial Man, un café. Madhumita, un chat. Adané, un camarade. Ella qui nous dit le courage. Luciana, le ciel. Fadoua Camille, un commerce. Denora, la cravate. Spiritual Weapons, cependant, très bien. Yulia, chouette. Chouette, c'est bien. Chouette, c'est vraiment chouette. Cheryl qui nous dit un chat. Dalil qui nous dit une cuillère. Attention, accent grave. Yann Arte, comment? Yesero. Non, Yesero. I'm not reading it. You know it. But it's correct. It's the feminine form. Josh, une chanson. Urmila, un cadre. Victoria Posse, commencez. Ben Terdongo, une compagnie. Shahi, celui-ci. Celui-ci, hein, remember that it's si, celui-ci, celui-là. Fadoua, des crevettes, miam miam. Roman, comme si, comme ça. Be careful, you write si, c-i. And then ça, c-c-d-i-a. Omar, une communication, la communication, féminin. Cassandra, un cadeau. Abdulrahman, un copain, un cousin. Victoria Jacques, un canard, ah oh oui. Est-ce que c'est l'animal? L'animal est très beau, mais moi je pense plutôt au côté gastronomique. C'est pas bien. Adané, une chanson. Annie, une cacahuète. Vouslat, le courage masculin. Renato, la côte, effectivement. Chériline, la calorimétrie. Donc c'est féminin. Hein. Andrea, elle s'appelle Johnny. Ah, Johnny Waf Waf. Très bien. Ensuite, Rock qui nous dit un chat. Victor. On va toujours parler. On parle toujours gastronomie ici. Hein. Le cassoulet. Allez, trouvez un mot qui commence avec la lettre A. Try to find one word that starts with the letter A. Six doigts, Stardust can use six fingers and it's the beginning of, I mean the freedom. Six fingers for Stardust, je dis bravo. Alors maintenant, regardons les mots. Let's have a look at your words. Cosmina, abîmé. Fadwa, amour. Ella, un amateur. Anvi, alimentaire. Yenitsomo, une année. D'accord. Renato Silva, amélioré. Victoria Possé, l'aube. Yanarte, acheté. Romande qui nous dit après. Urmila qui nous dit amour encore. C'est très populaire, amour, j'ai l'impression. Tout le monde cherche. Personne ne trouve. Spiritual Weapons, une assiette. Hilary, ancienne. Dalil, aimé. Yossi, amélioré. Luciana Moribé, ange peut-être. Un ange. Habibi, l'amour aussi. Yulia qui nous dit un arc-en-ciel. Ça, c'est magnifique. Vlad qui nous dit un arbre. Yesero, une encre. Cheryl qui nous dit aimé. Fadwa, une anesthésie. Darktainer, une ambulance. Très bien. Denora, une adaptation. Faites attention, Denora. La adaptation à... I have to drop from your article, so you will put the apostrophe. Annabelle Nouvelle, un apéritif. C'est délicieux. Un apéritif, c'est formidable. Avec des amis, avec la famille, c'est toujours agréable. Josh a rangé. Aldo qui nous dit animaux, des animaux. Victoria Jacques, un agneau. Alors, c'est pas si ça. Oui, après, vous continuez un ragoût d'agneau. Oh, ça, c'est bon. Oh mon Dieu, ça c'est délicieux. Rock, un avocat. You don't need to put the D, Rock, avocat. Chrismo, des araignées, effectivement. Omar, un ange. Vlad, ancien. So please, if you could just put one word, because after that it will never stop. So that's the reason why. Only one word would be really, really nice. Mercurial Man, un alligator. Shahi, une amie. Stardust, un chat. Miaou, miaou. Et Andrea qui nous dit abattu. c'est pas très joyeux ça. Advi qui nous dit un acteur. Allez, go for it. Now I would like one word. Please, one word per person, because after that it will be extremely, extremely long. So, one word with U as a first letter. Merci. Alors, Dalil qui nous dit « utilise », très bien, le verbe « utiliser ». Spiritual Weapons qui nous dit « une usine », Benter, une université, très bien. Yenny qui nous dit « utiliser », Ella qui nous dit « une université aussi ». Alors, Cosmina, ultra crépidarianisme. Vous avez une liste. Vous avez une liste. Ce sont des mots très utiles. Très utiles. Oumila qui dit union féminin. Cheryline, qui dit une. Yesero qui dit unique. Luciana qui nous dit l'univers. Stardust, juste après l'univers. Denora, it's masculine by the way, un univers. Denora, l'urbanisme. You've been forgetting the M. Renato Silva, incertain. Remember that, Renato? In fact, incertain starts with I and not U in French. This is the English version that you've been giving us. Dark Tainer, mon univers. Victoria Possé, utile. Habibi qui nous dit une. Très bien. Hilary qui nous dit utiliser. Wenjin, Jing, qui dit une. Très bien. Ella, l'univers ou les univers. Il y a aussi un umlaut. D'accord. Ah, effectivement, le umlaut. Je me souviens quand j'ai étudié l'allemand. Envy, insupportable. Be careful, envy, insupportable. Start with I and not U. Yann Arte, une unité. Darktainer, un oncle. Be careful, in French, Darktainer, oncle start with O. It's not like in English. Fatima, une union. Très bien. Roman, same thing here. Roman, it's in English, this one. It's not French at all. Fadoua, une usine. Cassandra, urbain. Omar, unique. Josh, incroyable. Be careful, Josh, because incroyable starts with I in French. Andrea, unification, féminin. Julia, une urgence. Victoria Jacques, uniquement. Rock, ultérieurement, très bien. Vouslat, ultraviolet. Et Cheryline, uridine. Merci beaucoup. Allez, the numbers of the day. Well, as usual, so we'll have a dictation of numbers. I will just read them twice, and then you just need to write them. D'accord? So we'll start with, obviously, a number with one digit. And so, just give me one second. I need to scroll. Now I can see it. So, I will read it twice. Trois. Trois. Write it, please. Alors, oui, this one was not really difficult, so from what I can see, everybody found it, so it's quite good, in fact, félicitations. So the second one will have, obviously, two digits, so let's start, and I will read it now. 27, 27, write it. Alors, attention, attention, Dark Tainer, you were not generous enough. Huh? It was 26, I mean, the thing that you've been writing, but in fact, it was 27. D'accord, so you just heard, and it sometimes it can be quite tricky huh, to make the difference. 6-7, I mean, it's true that they're quite close. So in that situation, it was 27. So from what I can see, it seems that everybody got it. Or almost everybody, d'accord, so don't worry if, ah d'accord, it was a wrong digit, but it's okay, don't worry. Alors, Julia, il est joli, mais avec les trucs rouges et verts. Well, you need to tell me. You need to tell me what's better for your interface. I mean, if the dark background is better, I mean, for me, it's okay. I just had to make it, but I mean, it's not a problem. C'est avec plaisir. Allez, let's continue with the number 3 digits, and same thing, I will read it twice. 634 634. Alors, je regarde 634. Well, it seems to be quite good. Huh? So in that case, obviously 100 is 100. So when you combine it with 6, remember that you won't pronounce the s in the end. 600. And then after that, you have 34. 634. 634, that was the thing that you had to find. I'm looking at the things and everything seems to be quite okay. Ice Cube is joining us, coucou coucou, and then Anvi is saying, j'aime vos vidéos, merci beaucoup, but you need to participate. You need to participate to make the exercises. This is the only way to get better. Numéro 4, so we'll have 4 digits in that case. Let's go for it. 2650. 2650. Chris Mo, what do you say? Chris Mo, DJ Vincent, aka DJ Spinny Vinny. Well, maybe. Vincent, remember, it's 20 cents too. Alish, it's going quite fast, so you are extremely efficient, and I must say that it's really good. It is really good. So the first thing is 1000, and so in that case we have 2000, so 2000, and after that, one more time, 100 is 100, 600 will be 600. 2650. And it was really good. Everybody wrote it perfectly. Je dois dire bravo. Bravo à tout le monde. Bravo. Let's continue with the numéro 5. Numéro 5. Look, we'll have obviously, and it will be the last one for this level, 5 digits. Attention, attention. 92 328. 92 328. Allez-y. Alors, je regarde. Oui, c'est bien. So, one more time, 1,000 is 1,000. So, in that situation, 92,000, 92,000. And then, 100, 100, 300, 300. 328, 328. 92,000, 328. So it was in fact quite good. Qu'est-ce que c'est? Julia, is it iced flour in your glass? No, c'est no, it's just ice. It's not a flour. Why not? It's a good idea. Merci. Alors, Tashi is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Don't forget to click on the like. Thank you very much. And do the exercises with us. Allez, what is she thinking about? À quoi pense-t-elle? Just imagine, write me a beautiful sentence. And then we'll discuss about that together. Alors, Viborai qui dit, I've got already the C2. Okay, well, if you've got the C2, it would be interesting. You should join us in 2 days and then we'll see if you master the passé simple. I will quiz you. If you've got the C2, I mean, you must be unbeatable for the passé simple. I'm not going to put some flowers in my thing, ice cubes. It would be extremely strange to drink some flowers, mais on ne sait pas. On ne sait pas, tout est possible. Dark Tainer qui dit « La vie est dure quand je dois travailler ». Eh oui. Yesero, elle pense à la prochaine étape qu'elle doit faire pour réparer la machine. Dalil nous dit « Elle pense qu'elle est très fatiguée ». C'est possible, effectivement. Anvi, elle pense à ses copains, à ses amis. Eh oui. Andrea, c'est bon, j'ai fini. Mais ce boulon. André, you've been fixing some things like that. You're certain that the thing is done, it's fixed, and then there is one part. It was inside at one point. And of course, the machine doesn't work. Cheryl pense à rien. Josh qui dit, elle pense à sa famille. Luciana, je ne sais pas si l'égalité des genres, c'est une bonne idée. Ah ben c'est... Yann Arte, elle pense à son travail. Stardust, elle pense que je peux faire tout ce que les hommes peuvent. Shahi, je pense qu'elle a travaillé dans la mécanique, vous voulez dire, oui. Ella Dongo, elle pense que le travail n'est pas facile, c'est vrai. Yulia qui dit, je finirai ce truc et j'irai m'acheter un kebab. Il y a une chanson sur le kebab. Une chanson de Fatal Bazooka. Ce soir, je t'emmène au kebab. Et Yasmine l'aimait bien. Yenny, elle pense comment réparer cette machine. Spiritual Weapons, alors je suis comme Rosie Riveter. Je ne connais pas cette personne. Mercurial Man, quelle heure est-il? Ice Cube, je ne sais pas ce qu'elle pense. Après avoir envoyé le devis, je me sens très fatigué lundi comme d'habitude. Ah, ben voilà. Eh ben voilà, Ice Cubes. Hop, le frigo, une petite boisson caféinée, et après ça va. Hillary qui dit, je veux m'asseoir. Omar, je pense qu'il y avait plusieurs pièces avant. Ouais, c'est le problème. Vouslat, elle pense à ses vacances d'autrefois. Rock, quelle vieille machine! Denora, NASA et la suivante. Oui, c'est ça en fait. Yossi, elle doit faire attention lorsqu'elle travaille à côté de la machine. Sneha qui nous dit bonjour, bonjour. Bonjour, participez. Donc ce cours, hein, this lesson will be in English and in French. Tomorrow it will be only in French and the day after too. Hadidi, je pense à demain, je vais aller à l'école. Roman, elle pense qu'elle va finir de travailler maintenant, d'accord. Renato, elle pense qu'aujourd'hui est dur. Annabelle, je suis la plus jolie pour faire ce travail. Ah, je ne sais pas si elle pense à ça, peut-être, on ne sait pas. Victoria, elle pense, quand j'ai fini de travailler, je prends un café. Oui, un bon café. Olga, elle pense qu'elle doit travailler très dur. Cassandra, elle pense à un beau monsieur qui l'attend après le travail pour l'emmener à dîner. Cosmina, elle pense qu'elle n'a pas bien assorti ses fingants avec la chemise en dentelle. Vous pensez qu'elle aurait dû avoir des gants en dentelle, blancs bien sûr. Vibor qui nous dit, elle pense à comment elle pourrait rentrer plus tôt. Eh oui. Allez, Ice Cubes, il faut aller contrôler. Allez contrôler le frigo, c'est nécessaire. Et Luciana vous dit qu'il faut cliquer. Merci. Allez, l'exercice classique. How would you translate? Remember, this is the classic exercise that we have for this level. So, premier, look at that. So, it's actually, I wanted to review some verbs that we've been seeing last week. So, last week, I think it was last week, yes, we've been seeing these verbs that belongs to the second group. So, ending in ER. If you were there, we've been trying to make the connection between these verbs and the adjectives. So now I want to check if you remember these verbs. So how could you translate to soften in French? Allez-y. And as usual, Julia is just inventing a new verb that doesn't yet exist, souplifier. It's a great one. But it doesn't exist. It's not souplifier. Souplifier doesn't exist yet. So remember that we saw this verb, last week. And in fact, so all the verbs will end with ER. Huh? So it's a tip. Remember that all the verbs that we will see for this exercise will end with ER. So the verb is adoucir. Huh? Remember, this is what we saw last week. Adoucir is connected to the adjective doux and douce, soft. Hein? Allez, let's have a look at numéro 2, to weaken. How could you say that in French? And don't forget, please, because you are almost 100 to watch, to click on the like. It would be really, really nice. I would be so happy. Darktainer, it does exist now. No, because we need to pass the process of the French Academy. So now we need to start to, because I've got a long list of the verbs or the words that the students are making, which are extremely great, but still the French Academy is not that flexible. We'll be right back. Alors, regardons. I try to avoid to look at Julia's answer because each time I want to laugh. Alors, the adjective is faible, remember? So you can start maybe from the adjective and try to find the verb again if you remember it. If you don't remember it, then it's a good sign because it means that maybe you should try to make a list. The verb is affaiblir. Affaiblir, so it belongs to the second group, as I told you. Let's have a look at numéro 3. Ice Cubes is trying to invent some things too. My God, it's like a virus. Julia has been introducing a virus in the group. Let's invent some words. Well, we should try to make an exercise about that. It could be fun. Alors, two round, and Andrea is saying, at least Andrea is honest, and it's good. Andrea is just saying that it's difficult for me in English, I'm just copying what the others are putting, but it's okay, no worries about that. Alors voilà, remember that this one, of course, it's connected to the adjective, as I explained, and the adjective is rond, d'accord? The verb that will be constructed based on this adjective rond will be arrondir. So you can see that you double the R, you put A in front, and then because it belongs to the second group, it will end with IR. Arrondir, it's to round. Arrondir, to make something round. Remember, we covered that last week. Numéro 4, to whiten. How could you say that in French? Allez-y. Alors, Darktainer is the first one to write, well, in fact, yes. So the verb is connected to the adjective. The adjective is blanc or then blanche, remember? And so the verb that will be constructed on that is blanchir. Blanchir, to whiten. So far, so good. Félicitations. Numéro 5. Numéro 5, let's have a look. And it's to harden. To harden, how could you say that, well, in French? Alors, Michael Oliveras is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Don't forget to click on the like. It would be nice and participate. Michael, we are right now doing some translations based on an exercise that we did last week. Last week, we've been discovering some verbs from the second group that are that have some direct connection to adjectives. And in that case, now, the idea would be to try to see if you remember them. D'accord? So to harden is, and look at the others, félicitations. The verb, sorry, is durcir. Remember, Julia, don't forget the C, durcir. D-U-R-C-I-R. Fortir, not really, Scott. Fortir doesn't yet exist. Ordurir. Ah, we got some interesting. Only one, Julia. Don't go for the. Don't get wild. Allez, numéro 6. Numéro 6. To uglify or to make ugly. How could you say that in French? Alors, I can see that it takes a little while because maybe you don't remember them. Oh, je dois dire bravo. Bravo, bravo, Cheryline. Hein? So, the adjective is lay or then led, remember. But then in that case, the verb, you will have to add this en in front of your adjective, and then after that you put ir. En les dire is in fact the verb to uglify or to make something ugly, en les dire. So the adjective, one more time, it's les, L-A-I-D, feminine form, led, L-A-I-D-E. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 7. Numéro 7, to enrich. To enrich, how could you say that in French? So let's remember that all these verbs belong to the second group, so they will have to end with IR, d'accord? So it's a tip already. Alors voilà, the adjective is riche, remember, riche, you write it R-I-C-H-E, but then when you will construct, in fact, the verb, you will go for enrichir. So as we had previously, en les dire, in that case, it will be enrichir, d'accord? Camille Galaxy saying, yeah! It's not a verb. Camille Galaxy, it's not a verb. Yeah. Allez, let's see. Numéro 8. To thicken. How could you say that in French? Alors, remember that if you didn't have the time to click on the like, well, it's now or never. it's the possibility to be nice with me. Alors, in that case, we're talking about this dimension, in fact, when you say épais ou mince. So, in fact, Cosmina, when you go for grossir, well, it depends on the context. In some cases, it might be acceptable. But let's agree that the direct translation would really be épaissir, because épais, it's really the adjective thick. So, Cheryline had it. Remember that you have to put double S, deux S. So, E, accent aigu, if you've got the accent aigu on your keyboard. And then P-A-I-S-S-I-R. Épaissir is the verb that we're looking for. Numéro 9, to broaden, to expand. Alors, and in that case, you can see that, yes, be careful, French language is a tricky language because you see that enlargir, in fact, doesn't exist, but we will keep the adjective large, but we will put a accent aigu in front, so it's élargir. Élargir is the verb that we will use to express this to broaden, to expand concept. D'accord. Viborai, you literally sound like my French teacher. It's good. It is good. Numéro 10. Numéro 10. To beautify, to embellish. Say hello to your French teacher from me with the same voice. Alors, Shahi, pourquoi pas grandir? Because grandir, it's when you do the thing on your own. So the idea was to in fact, do the action, to make something bigger. So it's slightly different, and this is the concept. So in that situation, well, the adjective is obviously that, I mean, the one we saw previously, remember, it was beau, belle, and belle. So this is the starting point, and after that, we will put E-M in front, and we end with ir. Embellir, embellir is in fact to beautify or to embellish. As you can see, there is some kind of connection with the English in that case. Well, that's the way it goes from time to time. You are almost 100, so please click on the like. Let us clear this 100 thing. And just after that, we can concentrate on the lesson. Alors, remember, à vos téléphones. So I'm not doing that, in fact, during this lesson. I thought that it might be more appropriate to do that during the intermediate and the advanced. So I've been receiving a few things, and don't forget, don't worry, I will put them, I won't forget, and I will put them for tomorrow and the day after. But if you want to share an event, if you just want to take a beautiful picture and write a little text in French, and it will be really nice. I mean, people have been, you have been doing that quite much, and it was really nice. So after that, of course, we try to put a little exercise with it. Most of the cases, it's a question, but send it to vosphotos@fluent2plus.com, and I will be really, really happy to put that during the lessons, and we'll make some exercises based on your pictures. Merci beaucoup. Ali, the classic, the word of the day. Could you give me one word to sum up your day? Un mot pour résumer votre journée, s'il vous plaît. Allez, Scott has to go. Au revoir, Scott. You can join us tomorrow and the day after, or during the whole the week, but not on Sunday. I will have to make some new rules next. I will put the same thing, but then I will say Victoria Jacques is not allowed to use fatigué. Because you're using too much fatigué. But it's true, when we're tired, we're tired. This is the winter. Winter time is not good. Vous slat lire. Elle a donc go fantastique. Wow. Alors là, elle a donc go Ah, on est jaloux, hein? Everybody is jealous now. Fantastic. You're just putting the level like that, hein? Andrea étude. Roman qui nous dit pense. Yossi visite. Très bien. Hilary commencer. Denora lire. C'est bien. Julia perdu. You're lost. Pas d'accent sur le E. Yenny prête. Je suis prête, prête à tout. Yesero qui nous dit réfléchir. Shahi qui dit durcir. Alors, Habibi, I'm blessed to be a part of this channel. Yeah, I mean, just join. It's fun to do that together. So please join Habibi and be with us. Josh, calme. Michael, divertissant. Ça, c'est pas mal. Yann Arte, me distraire. Annabelle, nouvelle, débordement. Qu'est-ce qui se passe, Annabelle? Il y a trop de choses. Parfois, la vie est difficile. Dark Diner, fantastique. Benter qui nous dit réfléchissant. Stardust, pluie. Ah, la pluie. Hein. Ah oui, la pluie. Il y a des chansons sur la pluie. J'ai une liste. Cassandra, n'oubliez pas de cliquer, c'est vrai. Omar qui nous dit travail. Ice Cubes, occupé. Victoria Jacques, but today I'm really very tired. New word for tomorrow. But it's okay if you're tired, you're tired. Et c'est vrai. Et c'est vrai. Si on est fatigué, c'est comme ça. Victoria Posse, lire. Chris Mo, abstraite. Alors, attends. Ice Cubes, tu ressembles à un saint. Ice Cubes, I will make a lesson and I will present to you one of my ancestors because I've got the luck to have in my family tree a saint. So maybe that's the reason why I've got the stuff behind me. But it's true. It's true, in fact. I have a saint as an ancestor. Cassandra, ensoleillé. Kang, surpris. Tashi, magnifique. Rock, belle nature. Luciana, recherchée. Et Stardust is laughing. Allez, the dictation of the day. One second, I just need to get ready there. I am putting the first one, remember, I will read some sentences and you will have to write them. I will read them two times, which I think is enough normally. I mean, this is the way it's been going. Allez, on y va. Attention, attention. Il a décidé de faire une tarte aux pommes pour son fils. Il a décidé de faire une tarte aux pommes pour son fils. Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at the structure, the sentence now. In that case, the first part, in fact, is the verb décider. Décider is in the passé composé tense. So remember that when you will construct décider in the passé composé, you will have to use the helping verb avoir. So avoir should be in the present. Il a. D'accord? And then décider, well, as we saw, when we are making these compound tenses, the second part will be called this past participle of décider is décider with an accent aigu in the end. De faire should definitely be in the infinitive. Tarte is a feminine word, so the article is une. Be careful, Hilary, because you've been writing un, but in fact, I've been really pronouncing the feminine form une, d'accord? Une tarte. Kangli, be careful, it was not un tarte, but it's really une tarte. D'accord? I tried to pronounce as strongly as I could the tarte. Aux pommes, because we are not using only one apple when we're making this thing. In most of the cases, you use at least two, I guess. We need to be generous with the apples. So you will have to put the plural form aux, and then pomme with S in the end, pour son fils, hein, remember, but then I'm looking, no, you've been writing it really properly, the fils, hein? So it's quite interesting because in fact, normally final S is not pronounced in most of the cases, we always have some exceptions, but in this situation, we really pronounce the S, and strangely, we don't pronounce the L, hein? Fils, F-I-L-S, you don't pronounce the L, you pronounce the final S. Il a décidé de faire une tarte aux pommes pour son fils. Deuxième phrase. Attention, attention. Ice cubes. Ice cubes, it's interesting. Let's take one second to make a break. Because in that case, if you just use one apple, juste une pomme, c'est une tarte à la pomme. C'est pas une tarte aux pommes, c'est une tarte à la pomme. We agree, hein? One apple for... Non, Ice Cubes. You need to take a picture. Ice Cubes, vous faites une tarte et vous prenez la photo. Take a picture of your apple pie with one apple, because I want to see it. Je veux vraiment la voir. C'est très intéressant. Attention. Elle va devoir s'habituer à nouveau à faire tout chez elle. Elle va devoir s'habituer à nouveau à faire tout chez elle. Allez-y. And Stardust, she's coming to rescue and to protect Ice Cubes. She's saying, "But it's a big apple she's using. Maybe, but I want the picture now." Alors, in that case, well, we use the verb devoir, and then I wanted to put the near future, so basically it means that we're going to use aller, that we conjugate in the present, elle va. Then devoir needs to be in the infinitive form, elle va devoir. After that, the verb s'habituer should be also in the infinitive. À nouveau, don't put anything in the end. It's not in the plural form, nouveau. It's only the singular form. So, à is the preposition. So, it should definitely be with the accent on the top if you have the accent on your keyboard. À faire. So, in that case, it's the infinitive. I'm looking at the things at the same time. Well, it's good. You've been writing it quite properly. Tout chez elle. Tout, in that situation, it should be written T-O-U-T, which you did quite well, in fact. Chez elle, well, remember, chez, C-H-E-Z. Chez elle. Elle va devoir s'habituer à nouveau à faire tout chez elle. Allez, on continue avec la troisième phrase. Troisième phrase, so it's the third one. Remember, I will just do exactly the same way. I will read it first, two times. Tout le monde attend le printemps avec impatience. Tout le monde attend le printemps avec impatience. Allez-y. Alors, I'm looking at the things that you're writing already. And yeah, it's quite good. Remember, Cassandra, when we have the expression tout le monde, in that case, because le monde is singular and it's masculine, so you should definitely use the basic form T-O-U-T. This is the basic, it's tout. Then after that, le monde. Roman, don't forget to put E in the end of monde. Tout le monde. After that, the verb. So the verb is attendre. D'accord? Attendre should definitely be conjugated in the third person, because even if this tout le monde concept is in fact plural, but grammatically it's only singular. So attend should definitely be conjugated in the third person of the singular. A-T-T-E-N-D. Le printemps. So le printemps, I'm looking at that. Yeah, no, you've been writing it quite well. Be careful, Roman. You've been hearing la pratique, but it's le printemps. It's the season. Hein? Le printemps avec impatience. And Victoria Jacques, je suis d'accord avec la phrase. Tout le monde attend le printemps avec impatience. Allez, numéro 4. Allez, je vais la lire deux fois. Il invite tous ses amis à manger une bonne raclette. Il invite tous ses amis à manger une bonne raclette. Écrivez la phrase. Alors, let's look at your sentences and at mine. So in that case, il invite. So I didn't make a liaison. So basically, you understand that it's the singular form in that case. So it should be il, I-L. Then invite, I-N-V-I-T-E. So this is the verb inviter that you will conjugate in the third person of the singular. Extremely regular verb. Il invite. After that, tous ses amis. So in that case, as you can see, we have the plural ses amis. So it means that tout should definitely be in the plural form, masculine plural, T-O-U-S. And you don't pronounce the final S. Tous ses amis. À manger. In that case, it's the preposition. À manger should definitely be in the infinitive form, M-A-N-G-E-R, une. Bonne. So in that situation, you put obviously the adjective bon in the feminine form, because raclette is feminine, B-O-N-N-E. Une bonne raclette. Il invite tous ses amis à manger une bonne raclette. Alors, I can see that Victoria Jacques is saying, je voudrais essayer une raclette. Hey, you know what? Victoria Jacques, right after the lesson, take the plane, come. I am doing a raclette with my friends today. So this is the reason why I've been writing that. And Julia, mais non, I don't know what I want. Raclette ou tarte aux pommes, c'est pas la même chose. C'est pas la même chose. Alors, Darktainer, c'est quoi une bonne raclette? You need to Google the raclette, Darktainer, and then you will see some beautiful pictures. It's something with cheese. You will warm and heat the cheese, and after that you will put that with everything you want. With everything you want, but the cheese. And then your house will smell for days after. It will smell for days, but still you will have had the pleasure of having this raclette, which is incredible. Allez, the last one, on y va. Dans sa famille, virgule, tout le monde se marie avec des étrangers. Dans sa famille, virgule, tout le monde se marie avec des étrangers. Étranger. Allez-y. It's okay, Victor et Jacques. Take the next flight. I've got the equipment. Alors, Cosmina is the first one. Dans sa famille, tout le monde se marie avec des étrangers. Yes, Ero, right after. Tout le monde. Yeah, you've been forgetting at the end of monde, and then you didn't conjugate se marie. So let's have a look at the sentence. Dans sa famille. So this one, I think it's not really difficult. And from what I see right now, you didn't make any mistakes. So dans, we agree that we write it D-A-N-S. After that, we will put the possessive in the feminine form because famille is feminine. So sa, because famille will be feminine in that case. So, dans sa famille. Tout le monde. So, same thing here. It's tout, because monde is masculine. So, we need to put tout, the masculine, singular form, T-O-U-T. Then after that, le monde. Well, I guess you've been writing it properly. I'm looking at the things that are arriving. Be careful, Denora, it was not la monde, but it's le monde. D'accord? Yeah, Ella Dongo, be careful, it's not the plural. It's not les mondes, but it's really le monde. Tout le monde. After that, the verb is se marier. D'accord? Same thing here. When you have tout le monde, I mean, the concept is plural, but grammatically, it is really, really singular. So, se marie should be conjugated in the third person of the singular. Se marie, M-A-R-I-E. First group, extremely regular, avec des étrangers. Étranger, remember to write it like you can see on the screen. If you have the accent, it should be there on the first E, before the T. And then in the end, it's E-R-S. E-R-S, étranger, which means foreigners. Dans sa famille, tout le monde se marie avec des étrangers. And I can see on the screen that I mean, there are four likes missing. Come on, please be nice. Click on the like. My little pleasure is to reach the 100, and I'm pretty sure we can do it today. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Allez, imaginez, que dit-il? Just imagine, what does he say? Que dit-il? One sentence, please. Julia, in this sentence, how can we differentiate if it's his family or her family? You don't. In that case, you can't. But everything is contextual, so it's according to the context. And if you really want to make a point, in that case, you will use dans la famille de, and then you put the name of the person. So if it comes like that, obviously, then you will go with the name of the person. If you go for the possessive, it's somehow because you've been mentioning the person previously and you don't want to repeat the thing. I mean, it's just a concept of the pronouns too. You just want to avoid repeating something. So this is the reason why. But truly, grammatically, you don't hear any difference now. Alors, Sony qui dit « Il parle de ses problèmes ». Anvi qui nous dit « Pourquoi dors-tu à l'école ?» Parce qu'il est fatigué. Il est fatigué. Et là, je suis « J'ai ». Remember to use the verb « avoir hein. ».« J'ai un problème avec ma mère ». Dark Tainer, je... Alors, j'attends à toi mon amour pour toujours. Je t'attends, maybe, pour toujours. Hillary, j'ai raison. Just like that. J'ai raison. Shahi, ils sont frères et sœurs. Yesero, il essaye d'expliquer tous ses problèmes à sa psychologue, mais il a du mal. C'est pas facile, peut-être. Mercurial, oui, c'est vrai que je suis le meilleur. Ça, c'est intéressant. Alors, attendez. Roman, I don't know why I need to click to have your thing. Alors, attendez-vous, Slat, il dit qu'il va entrer dans la politique, peut-être. Denora, votre compagnie a besoin de moi. Votre entreprise a besoin de moi. Stardust, il dit à sa thérapeute, hein, c'est une femme, que sa vie est si terrible et qu'il aimerait redevenir enfant. It would be so great. Going back to your childhood. Ah oh, oui, c'est formidable. Victoria Jacques, alors tu dis que tu aimerais essayer une raclette? And right after he's going back in the thing, bringing the thing. Oh, la raclette. Délicieux. Luciana, comment est-ce qu'elle m'a dit ça? Omar, je crois qu'il y a quelque chose de bizarre avec moi. J'ai le même rêve chaque nuit. Yossi, il raconte son premier voyage autour du monde. Cosmina, mais vous croyez qu'il a toujours le pouvoir de dire quelque chose? Le regard de la mademoiselle. Oui, je pense que c'est une thérapeute, hein, Cosmina. Je crois que c'est une psychologue, mais bon. Annabelle, je sais exactement comment faire ça. Roman, ma distension est mon grand parce que je peux faire ce que je veux. Not sure I understood the beginning of your sentence, Roman, but the rest, it was good. Julia, désormais, tu peux manger tous les desserts sans grossir. Ben, peut-être, ce serait formidable, imaginez. Detso, il discute de quelque chose, c'est vrai. Cosmina, le regard de la mademoiselle l'a pétrifié dans cette position. Ah, puis elle prend des notes. Hein. She's taking some notes. It's not a good sign. Aha! Repeat that. Ice Cubes. Il dit, écris bien, ma chère secrétaire, une tarte aux pommes. Non, à la pomme. Existe. Yeah, there is only one place in the world and it's your home, Ice Cubes. C'est le seul endroit, peut-être. Well, maybe it could be a special, a new recipe, une tarte à la pomme. Michael, il est avec un psychiatre qui voit des choses. Tashi, elle pose quelques questions. Yann Arte, il enseigne l'étudiante en français. Peut-être, elle prend des notes en tout cas. Daria, coucou Daria. Oh, c'est pas vrai. Daria is just joining us for the good news.
Ha ha ha.
I am doing my little minimalistic dance. Allez, 100, merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup, en tout cas. On continue. Alors, quelle est la différence entre le politique et la politique, vous, Slat? La politique, c'est la discipline. Le politique, c'est un homme politique, hein, voilà, si vous préférez. Mais en général, on dit un homme politique, mais c'est le politique. Well, the discipline will be the feminine one, hein, la politique. Chris Mo, 20 raisons pour en faire un copain. 20 raisons, pourquoi? C'était pas clair. Allez, it's the best place, c'est le meilleur endroit pour imaginer la suite. Alors, Dark Tainer commence et nous dit « C'est le meilleur endroit pour acheter de la nourriture. » Anvi, « C'est le meilleur endroit pour aller aux toilettes. » Qu'est-ce que c'est que cette histoire, Anvi, pour aller aux toilettes? Je ne sais pas pourquoi. Shahi, « C'est le meilleur endroit pour faire du business. » Yesero, « C'est le meilleur endroit pour trouver des matériaux pour faire du bricolage. » Yossi, c'est le meilleur endroit pour y travailler. Yulia, c'est le meilleur endroit pour se perdre. C'est vrai, tout se ressemble. Mercurialman, c'est le meilleur endroit parce que personne n'est là. Ensuite, Chrismo, c'est le meilleur endroit pour danser avec cette musique avec des strobes. Peut-être que je devrais m'équiper. David Ben, c'est le meilleur endroit pour prendre un café. Vous êtes comme ça? Peut-être, je ne sais pas. Hillary, c'est le meilleur endroit pour se cacher, c'est vrai. Detso, c'est le meilleur endroit pour acheter des boissons. Victoria Posse, c'est le meilleur endroit pour devenir déprimé. Ça, c'est vrai aussi. Stardust, si vous souhaitez rénover votre maison, c'est une quincaillerie. Oui, oui, vous pouvez dire une quincaillerie. Romande, c'est le meilleur endroit pour travailler et apprendre à faire des choses. Denora, c'est le meilleur endroit pour être verrouillé pour une semaine, enfermé, enfermé pour une semaine. Victoria Jacques, c'est le meilleur endroit pour acheter des choses, pour réparer des choses. Cosmina qui nous dit, c'est le meilleur endroit pour bâtir une carrière solide et pleine de fric. Fric au singulier, Cosmina, pas de S, pas de S. Luciana, c'est le meilleur endroit pour stocker les courses. Omar, c'est le meilleur endroit pour se perdre en faisant les courses. Merci beaucoup. Allez, let's continue with the translations because I think it's always interesting. In that case, we'll concentrate on the verbs if I remember properly. No, it was not verbs, I'm sorry. It was sentences. So short sentences and quite simple sentences. So it's not verbs, but it's short sentences. How could you say I think about you in French? Allez-y. Alors, Akraf is joining us. Bonjour, comment ça va? Ça va très bien. You need to participate, so you need to make the exercise. And in that case, we are doing some translations, simple translations of sentences. Mm-hmm. Alors, in that case, we agree that the difficulty is to find the proper preposition with the verb penser. I mean, penser is not a real problem for you. I mean, you've been finding it, so it's quite good. So, je pense, but remember that you need to put the a, d'accord? Preposition will be a. After that, you've got two options. You can go for the toi, and then you can put the vous if you want, so it's possible. So, je pense à toi, je pense à vous. Alors, Lily is saying daddy. I don't really know what you mean. We are making some exercises for French, Lily. Try to make them. Allez, numéro 2, number 2. Number 2, I do the dishes. How could you say that in French? Merci. Alors, Dachteiner was the first one, but unfortunately you didn't want to conjugate the verb faire, which is not really nice, because obviously the verb faire should be conjugated. When you conjugate the verb faire in the first person, remember, it will be je fais, F-A-I-S, d'accord? Je fais, and after that, well, the expression goes with la vaisselle, je fais la vaisselle. I'm looking at the thing. Be careful, Hilary. Don't go for the plural. Same thing for Angéry. Don't go for the plural. Just go for the faire la vaisselle. Keep the singular. D'accord? And this is the expression. Je fais la vaisselle. Numéro 3. Numéro 3. I regret nothing. How could you say that in French? Alors, c'est Cosmina. Cosmina is the first one, and it seems that she's extremely, well, maybe she's a specialist, because of course, it makes you think about Edith Piaf. Non, rien de rien. Donc, je ne regrette. Be careful, Cosmina, you put two T, deux T pour regretter. D'accord? So, je ne, so the verb is regretter, and then you need to close it with the nothing concept. Remember, nothing concept will be ne, you put your verb, and after that you close it with rien. Ne rien. Je ne regrette rien. Effectivement, il mando. Edith Piaf, grand classique d'Edith Piaf, non, rien de rien. Non, je ne regrette rien. Elle a raison, il ne faut rien regretter. Numéro 4, I'm going to forget her. How could you say that, well, in French? Alors oui, you need to remember that a will have to drop from your pronoun. So, of course, it should be je vais la oublier. But remember that a and o, they don't really get along. So, a will have to be removed from your pronoun. And you will put the apostrophe je vais l'oublier. Hein? And so, because I am anticipating Julia's question... Yes, je vais l'oublier, when you take it like that, it can be for a person, So it can be for a man, or it can be for a woman, or it can even be for a thing. So, because in that case, it's just grammatical, this pronoun, all right? But then the concept is that these pronouns are usually used to avoid repeating something, so the thing was mentioned previously. This is the reason why we are using them after. You don't go straight like, je vais l'oublier, without having mentioned the thing that you didn't want to repeat previously. So, je vais l'oublier. This is the thing that we were looking for. Be careful, Michael. It's not lui, but it's really la in that case. And then you drop the A and you put the apostrophe. Numéro 5. Numéro 5. Regardez, regardez. I am going to cook tonight. How could you say that in French? Alors, well, it seems that we are going almost all of us in the same direction. So I wanted to use the verb cuisiner. Cuisiner is extremely simple in that case. You don't really need to. I mean, you can go for, Yesero wanted to use faire la cuisine, which it's possible to. Luciana went for the same. But you can really go with the cuisiner. Obviously, in that case, I mean, the concept will be to put the future proche, so je vais, remember the verb aller that you will conjugate in the present, je vais, and then you put cuisiner in the infinitive. Je vais cuisiner ce soir. Raphaël Obidan is a new person, so Raphaël, this lesson is almost finished now, but still it's in English and in French. Tomorrow it will be at the same time only in French, and the day after only in French too. So in that case, yeah, we were looking for je vais cuisiner ce soir. And Rommel is joining us too. Bonjour Rommel, I hope you're doing fine. We continue with the translations of the sentences. I don't want to talk. I don't want to talk. How could you say that in French? Allez, Darktainer is leaving us. Au revoir et à bientôt. Alors, Stéphanie is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. You can participate. The idea now is to translate some sentences, d'accord? Extremely simple sentences, so go for it. Alors, in that situation, yes, the idea would be to use the verb vouloir, d'accord? Vouloir should be in that situation in the present, because as you can see, it was in the present. Remember to conjugate it. It can be a bit tricky, because vouloir will, for the third, first persons, will be je veux, V-E-U-X, tu veux, V-E-U-X, il veut, V-E-U-T. So it means that the root is somehow changing. So in that situation, it's the first person, so je veux. Then after that, you put the negative form before and after your verb je ne veux pas. And you finish with the verb parler that should definitely be in the infinitive because it's the second verb and the first one was conjugated and it's vouloir. Je ne veux pas parler. Victor, remember that parler should be in the infinitive. Hein? I'm looking at the same time. Don't forget to put parler in the infinitive. Allez, on continue. Numéro 7. Number 7. I have to go out tomorrow. I have to go out tomorrow. How could you say that in French? Thank you. Alors, in that situation, the best option, the most simple one, would be to go, well, in fact, with the verb devoir, conjugated in the present, and after that, you put sortir in the infinitive. Je dois sortir demain. So this is the first one, extremely simple, and I would advise you to go for that. After that, if you want to start to play with falloir, because I can see that certain persons wanted to go with falloir. In that case, remember that falloir is a verb that must be conjugated in the third person of the singular, because it's an impersonal structure verb. Il faut. So, after that, you can play with two options. Cosmina went for that. If I, one second, I need to scroll one more time. Yeah, Cosmina, she went for il faut que j'aille dehors demain. So clearly, technically it's okay. It's a bit heavy. It's not so light. I mean, the sentence is grammatically correct, but maybe I would not go for that, but still it's good. Julia, I think she went for another structure that is interesting. Il me faut. And then in that situation, you just continue with the infinitive. Il me faut sortir demain, which is extremely, extremely good too. Yeah. Denora, you went for aller, which might, je dois aller demain. It's really strange because aller, it's not really to go out, it's really to go. So after that, I don't really know where you're going, in fact. So maybe you should use sortir instead of aller. D'accord? Allez, let's have a look at numéro 8. Yesero, et le futur simple. For this one? Yesero, future simple for the previous one or for which one? Please tell me, because in that situation, I have to go out tomorrow. Je devrais sortir demain. This is what you wanted to give me. I'm not sure. Please formulate Yesero one more time. Hein? Numéro 8, he has a vacation this week. How could you say that? Alors, Yesero, pour cette phrase, je dois sortir demain. You would like to put the thing in a future simple. It's a bit strange because think about that. Even in English, it would be quite strange to transpose that in the future. You could go for the future proche. Je vais devoir sortir demain. If you really want to go there, je devrais. But in that case, you don't put the S in the end. It would be another option. Je devrais sortir demain. It's possible. So you can play with the things. But in fact, the way it goes, you say, oh, remember that if you go for the present, it indicates something that it's a fact. So it's factual. So it means that I have to. If you go for the near future, in that case, it's something that is less probable than what you say in the present, but still it's extremely probable. If you go for the real future, it's farther from you. In that case, it means that it is highly probable, but you never know what might happen. So this is the way it goes. Alors, in that situation, il a des vacances. So remember that in French, we will use vacances in the plural form to indicate this vacation concept. Luciana wanted to go for congé, which would be a possibility. Congé, it's the same concept. I mean, same meaning. But then in fact, congé is more related to work. You just want to indicate that it's a break from the work. So if you want to say vacations, holidays, it's really vacances. This is the way we will do it, but in the plural form. Il a des vacances cette semaine. Remember that semaine is feminine, so definitely set should be in the feminine form. C-E-T-T-E. D'accord? Allez, let's have a look at numéro 9. Numéro 9. He wants to know his past. He wants to know his past. How could you say that in French? Alors, oui, hein, so in that case too, I mean, the verb is vouloir. In that case, vouloir should be conjugated in the third person of the singular. Il veut, V-E-U-T, hein, remember, it should be with the T. After that, the second verb is connaître. Connaître should be definitely in the infinitive form. So, because it's right after vouloir, that is conjugated, and then son. Passé, remember that passé is masculine, so son should be definitely the masculine form, S-O-N. I'm looking at, in that case, oui, savoir, it would be a bit strange to oui, Yesero, savoir à propos de son passé. It could be possible, but it's a bit heavy. It's a bit heavy. In fact, in that situation, this connaître would be the best option because you go for connaître and then you just put the word. In some cases, don't try to make the sentences too long. If it's possible to make them short, then in most of the cases, it's better. It's better to keep it short. Well, that's the way it goes. Numéro 10. Numéro 10. And it's true. It's for Nicolas, this one. I've been trying and trying. So he hates spinach. How could you say that? Alors, Raphaël, why not savoir? I've been making some videos regarding the difference between savoir and connaître. In fact, it's grammatical. And so I would really invite you to have a look at the videos. They are quite precise and you will have the answer to your question. It would be a bit too long to do it right now, because after that, people will get bored, I guess. So let's have a look at the thing. So il déteste. So I'm looking at the verbs. Yeah, in most of the cases, it's il déteste. He went for the n'aime pas. Why not? I mean, you can use aimer in the negative form. Remember that it's quite funny because we put that in the plural form. So we say les épinards. We usually put the plural form for les épinards. So il déteste les épinards. Excuse, fais lui manger des épinards avec du yaourt. Yeah, but he's not a big fan of yogurt either. Nicolas is a difficult client. When it comes to eating, he's a challenge. He's a challenge. C'est vraiment pas évident. Merci beaucoup en tout cas. Euh, Il Mondo, pourquoi pas des épinards? Because remember, Il Mondo, when you express your likes and dislikes in French, so when you go for aimer, détester, préférer, etc., remember that you will go with the article, the definite article. You say j'aime le chocolat. Je n'aime pas le chocolat. J'aime les épinards. Je n'aime pas les épinards. Same thing. It will be préféré, détesté, adoré. Same concept. You go for the definite article. Il Mondo. Voilà. Julia, est-ce que Nicolas aime la raclette? Just like that. Yeah, Julia, because it's not an option to stay in this place if you don't like raclette. It's not possible. You just need to exit the place. So it doesn't have any possibility. But no, of course he likes it. It's so good. Allez, on y va. What do you mean by that? So it will be the last exercise for today. What do you mean by that? And we're still struggling with these emojis, emoticon. I don't know what they mean. So what does this thing mean? How could you make a sentence to express and to explain what it means? Alors, Victoria Jacques is saying merci beaucoup, Vincent. So you're leaving. Au revoir, Victoria. Donc, Mercury Allman qui nous dit que ça veut dire menteur. Julia qui utilise bien, tu es mytho. Alors, souvenez-vous, c'est possible de dire tu es un mytho, un gros mytho. C'est possible aussi. Yesero, ça veut dire qu'il ment. Cheryline, tu es un menteur ou une menteuse. Luciana, c'est un mytho. Stardust, juste en disant Pinocchio. Oui, ben oui, c'est... Hein, c'est l'histoire de Pinocchio. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire, Detso? Bah, that's the concept. That's the concept. And this is the thing that I would like you to help us with. Stéphanie, quand vous avez dit un mensonge. Cosmina, il a... Qu'est-ce qu'il a sur le nez? Je ne sais pas ce que c'est. Yoram, il déteste les épinards. Well, you need to refresh, Yoram. You're a bit... you're not synchronized. Peut-être la confusion, dit Shahi. Hilary, merci beaucoup. So you have to go too? Okay, so... Ah, Victoria Jacques, you're still here. Ah non, I'm not leaving. I'm just finishing this one. Il Mondo, il fait Pinocchio. D'accord. Annabelle, Pinocchio, oui. Mais qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Ice Cube, je ne sais pas. Peut-être que je suis une menteuse ou je crois que tu es un menteur. D'accord. Omar, c'est un menteur comme dans le conte, donc dans l'histoire Pinocchio. Anvi, vous êtes comme une tarte. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Ah, je ne sais pas. Qu'est-ce que c'est comme ça? Ah, comme on a une tête de tarte, peut-être. Roman, je ne sais pas exactement, mais peut-être que nous mentons. Vouslat, ça veut dire menteur, peut-être. Raphaël, I'm a French student in my university. I was offered a course, but I don't know how to read well and speak. Help me, I want to speak well. Well, Raphaël, we have the live every days from Monday to Saturday, so you're welcome to join. Tomorrow it will be only in French, the day after only in French, and the following day in English, and so on. So we have six lessons per week. Michael, je dois travailler. Au revoir, Michael. Alors, it seems to... une bosse, nous dit Cosmina. Mais c'est pas une bosse, c'est le nez. Alors, let's have a look at the number two. It seems that you're not really clear on that. What does this one mean? I mean, I've been seeing that. What does it mean? Explain to me that. Alors, let's see. Shahi, ça veut dire froid. Maybe. I don't know. It seems that nobody knows exactly what it means. I mean, it's like... Alors, Cheryline, l'esprit soufflé. D'accord. Et là, il est confus. Stardust, donne-moi le cerveau. Ça, c'est pareil. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Donne-moi le cerveau. Detso, ah, surprise ou surpris. OK. Roman, quand quelque chose est trop compliqué. Hein? Luciana, le cerveau brûle. Sonic, il est perplexe. Peut-être. Rommel, je ne sais pas. Mercurial Man, je ne sais pas. Yannart, quoi? Julia, beaucoup d'informations, je suis bouleversée. D'accord, très bien. Mark Watson, I've been seeing your thing, but I'm not really sure. Give me a context, please. Give me a sentence. It's not really clear what you want to ask. So if you want to ask something, write a sentence. It will be more clear. Merci. Detso, mal de tête. Victoria Posse, pense beaucoup. Alors attendez. Omar, c'est un cerveau très fatigué. Denora, c'est trop pour moi. Cosmina, il aime tellement la polenta. C'est possible. Peut-être. Rommel, il faut essayer plus. Ah, vous, cela, je ne comprends pas. Voilà. Stéphanie, je ne sais pas. Pouf. And that's the thing. It's not really cool. Ah, Ice Cubes, tu m'époustoufles. Ah, peut-être. Il est choqué, nous dit Sonic. Yesero, ça veut dire que la personne ne croit pas la nouvelle. Rock, le cerveau va brûler, peut-être. Il Mondo, quoi, tu vas brûler ma tête. Victoria Jacques, je ne peux pas le croire que ton cerveau te fait mal. C'est possible. Alors, this one, numéro 3, qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? What does it mean? I mean, this one, I've been seeing it, but then I don't really know what it means. AJ, every day I listen to your voice going to work. It's my pleasure, AJ, but you should definitely try to participate. If you're driving, don't text. This is the only thing I ask you. Don't text if you're driving. But what does this emoji or emoticon means? One sentence, please. Mais alors, Marc, what's going on, Mark Watson? You want to write things about naked people, etc.? Well, Marc, let's agree on that. I will put you on hold for a few minutes because it seems that you're not really, you don't really want to participate, Marc. D'accord? Thank you very much. Alors, let's have a look at the things now. Luciana qui dit c'est le dégoût. Allo Kaisa qui pense que c'est le stress. Mohamed qui nous rejoint. Bonjour. Stéphanie qui dit c'est pas clair. We don't know now. Sonny qui vient de faire une erreur. Il ne croit pas qu'il est bête. Ah, so it's when you make a mistake and you just realize, oh, I'm so stupid, maybe. Stardust, le mal. Ha, ha, ha. Mercurial Man, je suis fâché. Ça, c'est intéressant. Yesero, la personne regrette car il a fait une grande erreur. Ah, d'accord. Sherilyn, c'est embarrassant. So it's slightly the same, but still you have some differences between the thing. Vous, Slat, je n'ai aucune idée. Just like me. Vous, Slat, you're like me. We don't know. Shahi, je suis triste avec vous. Well, you can see, I mean, this is not really clear. Nobody really agrees on the meaning of these things, so it's really interesting. Alors, merci beaucoup en tout cas. Let's have a look at Detso qui dit dépression. Numéro 4. Numéro 4, what about this one? This one, I saw it several times. I've got no clue what it means. I mean, of course, I can see a lady who is dancing, but what does it mean? Alors, Roman qui dit c'est pour danser, Sonic qui dit allons danser, Hamid qui dit c'est la fête, Shahi qui dit une jolie fille qui est contente. Il mondo, ça c'est formidable, d'accord. Allo Kaisa, dansons. Ice Cube, je déteste faire la même erreur. What does it mean? Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire, Ice Cube? Je déteste faire la... Ah, ok, you didn't refresh, maybe. Maybe it's not with the lady who is dancing. Sonic, nous sommes bien amusés. Yesero, cet emoji est utilisé quand tu as reçu de bonnes nouvelles. Ah, donc on danse? D'accord. Stardust, la vie est comme une danse sur un toit chaud. C'est dangereux, un toit chaud en été probablement. Mercurial Man, les moments heureux. Allo Kaisa, le flamenco peut-être. Roman qui dit voilà, qui est prêt, qui danse. Oui. Ensuite, Edie qui nous dit I guess you cannot pronounce my name right. I don't really know. Try it. I will try it. Detso, danser. Victor, la vie en rose. Julia, je suis heureuse. J'ai gagné une bonne nouvelle. Ah, donc ça, c'est la joie. Rock qui nous dit Cendrillon. Luciana, yeah, on a le pouvoir. Denora, je suis une gagnante. Ella Dongo, peut-être faire une fête aujourd'hui. Ah, donc c'est ça alors aussi. Yoram, elle va attraper son petit ami. Sherilyn, je danse par bonheur. Ice Cube, je danse comme les Espagnols. Eh ben oui, comme ça. Victoria Jacques, wouhou, je danse quand je suis heureuse. Très bien. Stéphanie qui nous dit danse. Et Cosmina qui nous dit... Peut-être que c'est ce que je préfère finalement. Elle fuit le mariage, mais d'une façon très très classieuse. Allez, that's it. It's the end because we need to stop and I have to prepare my raclette because I really want to have a good raclette tonight. So, thank you very much. Tomorrow, as you can see, it will be exactly at the same time, but it will be only in French. And the day after, it will be exactly the same thing. At the end of the week, we will celebrate, I don't really know how, but at least with a bottle for me. the anniversary or the birthday of the channel. Merci beaucoup, au revoir et à demain si vous voulez.
Mm-hmm.